Ladies and gentlemen, welcome to the MLK Showcase. Please give a warm welcome to the executive producer of this show, Miss Phyllis Bennett.
Good afternoon, everybody. Woo! What a wonderful day this is. We're so excited that you're here with us today. We appreciate your effort to come out to support our young people, and you're in for a real treat. But I'd like you to know right now, I'm standing in for Sherry Christian, and I'm standing in for her because her daughter is ill. And she sends her regrets. She wants you to know that she wanted to be here and that she loves each and every one of you. So give Sherry Christian in action a big round of applause. And ladies and gentlemen, I am deeply honored to introduce to you and to present to others my friend, Pastor Yvette Davis of the historic Grace United Methodist Church on State Street here in Harrisburg, and she will lead us in an invocation. Immediately following the invocation, we will rise for the national anthem sung by Joy Christian and remain standing for Lift Every Voice performed by Alice Penn. I present to some of you and introduce to others, Pastor Yvette Davis.
Good afternoon, everyone. Isn't this a wonderful day to celebrate? Amen. Let us pray. Gracious God, we give you praise today. We thank you, Father, for this wonderful opportunity to celebrate the legacy of the Reverend Dr. Martin Luther King. And Lord, you said in your word that our children are a gift and a treasure to us. And we give you praise, Lord God, for every child, every youth, every young adult, O God. And for all the many gifts that you have given each and every one. And we thank you, Lord, for this opportunity for them to share their gifts. And Lord, as we remember Dr. King, he was a young adult himself when he began to live into his call to change the world. And Lord, we know that you have given great gifts, that you have a divine plan for each and every one of our children, and that we don't even know that there is one of our young folks, Lord, there are many of our young folks today whom you have called to change the world. And we ask you, Father, that they will walk into that plan and that we will accept your call to come alongside them, to speak life into them, Lord, to support them in their gifts, and to always remember, oh God, that yes, they are our gifts, and that they are our treasure. And we praise you, Lord, for each and every one. And so, Lord, we turn this celebration over to you. We invite your holy presence into this place, and we thank you for all that you've done, all that you're doing, and all that you're going to do. In the name of our true Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ, we pray. Thank you, Lord, and amen.
Ladies and gentlemen, put your hands together for Miss Joy Christian as she sings the national anthem, and I ask you to
What's so proudly we hailed at the twilight's last gleaming, whose broad stripes and bright stars
gentlemen, Martin Luther King Jr. has arrived in the auditorium. So sit back and take in the full message as Michael Joyner delivers I Have a Dream speech as Martin Luther King Jr.
Join with you today in what will go down in history as the greatest demonstration for freedom in the history of our nation. 50 years ago, a great American in whose symbolic shadow we stand today signed the Emancipation Proclamation. This momentous decree came as a great beacon light of hope to millions of Negro slaves who had been seared in the flames of withering injustice. It came as a joyous daybreak to end the long night of their captivity. But 100 years later, the Negro still is not free. 100 years later, the life of the Negro is still sadly crippled by the manacles of segregation and the chains of discrimination. 100 years later, the Negro lives on a lonely island of poverty in the midst of a vast ocean of material prosperity. 100 years later, the Negro is still languished in the corners of American society and finds himself exiled in his own land. And so we've come here today to dramatize a shameful condition. In a sense, we've come to our nation's capital to cash a check when the architects of our republic wrote the magnificent words of the Constitution. In the Declaration of Independence, they were signing a promissory note to which every American was to fall in. This note was the promise that all men, yes, black men as well as white men, would be guaranteed the unalienable rights of life, liberty, and the pursuit of happiness. It is obvious today that America has defaulted on this promissory note insofar as her citizens of color are concerned. Instead of honoring this sacred obligation, America has given the Negro people a bad check, a check which has come back marked insufficient funds. But we refuse to believe that the Bank of Justice is bankrupt. We refuse to believe that there are insufficient funds in the great vault of opportunity of this nation. And so we've come to cash this check, a check that will give us upon the man's the riches of freedom and the security of justice. We have also come to this hollow spot to remind America of the fierce urgency of now. This is no time to engage in the luxury of cooling off or to take the tranquilizing drug of gradualism. And for those who do hope that the Negro needed to blow off steam and will now be content, we'll have a rude awakening if the nation returns to business as usual. There will be neither rest nor tranquility in America until the Negro is granted his citizenship rights. The whirlwinds of revolt will continue to shake the foundations of our nation until the bright day of justice emerges. But there is something that I must say to my people who stand on the warm threshold which leads into the palace of justice. In the process of gaining our rightful place, we must not be guilty of wrongful deeds. Let us not seek to satisfy our thirst for freedom by drinking from the cup of bitterness and hatred. We must forever conduct our struggle on a high plane of dignity and discipline. We must not allow our creative protest to degenerate into physical violence. Again and again, we must rise to the majestic heights of meeting physical force with soul force, the marvelous new militancy which has engulfed the Negro community. Must not lead us to a distrust of all white people. For many of our white brothers, as evidenced by their presence here today, have come to realize that their destiny is tied up with our destiny, that their freedom is inextricably bound to our freedom. We cannot walk alone. And as we walk, we must make the pledge that we shall always march ahead. We cannot turn back. There are those in the devotees of civil rights who are asking the question, when will you be satisfied? We can never be satisfied as long as the Negro is the victim of the unspeakable horrors of police brutality. We can never be satisfied as long as our bodies are heavy with the fatigue of travel. Cannot gain lodging in the motels of the highways and in the hotels of the city. We can never be satisfied as long as the Negro's basic mobility is from a smaller ghetto to a larger one. We can never be satisfied as long as our children are stripped of their selfhood and robbed of their dignity by signs stating for whites only. We can never be satisfied as long as the Negro in Mississippi cannot vote and the Negro in New York believes he has nothing for which to vote. No, no, we are not satisfied and we will not be satisfied until justice rolls down like waters and righteousness like a mighty stream. And so, even though we must face the difficulties of today and tomorrow, I still have a dream. It is a dream deeply rooted in the American dream. I have a dream that one day this nation will rise up, live out the true meaning of its creed, that we hold these truths to be self-evident, that all men are created equal. I have a dream that one day on the red hills of Georgia, the sons of former slaves and the sons of former slave owners we'll be able to sit down together at the table of brotherhood. I have a dream that one day, even the state of Mississippi, a state sweltering with the heat of injustice, sweltering with the heat of oppression, will be transformed into an oasis of freedom and justice. I have a dream that my four little children will one day live in a nation where they would not be judged by the color of their skin, but by the content of their character. I have a dream today. I have a dream that one day, down in Alabama with his vicious races, with his governor having his lips dripping with the words of interposition and nullification, one day right there in Alabama, little black boys and black girls will be able to join hands with little white boys and white girls as sisters and brothers. I have a dream today. I have a dream that one day every valley shall be exalted. Every hill and mountain shall be made low, the rough places will be made plain, and the crooked places will be made straight, and the glory of the Lord and all flesh shall see it together. This is our hope. This is the faith that I go back to the South with. With this faith, we will be able to go out of the mountain of despair, a stone of hope. With this faith, we will be able to transform the jangling discourse of our nation into a beautiful symphony of brotherhood. With this faith, we will be able to work together, to pray together, to struggle together, to stand up for freedom together, knowing that we will be free one day. This will be the day when all of God's children will be able to sing with new meaning. My country, 'tis of thee, sweet land of liberty, of thee I sing. land where my fathers died, land of the pilgrim's pride. From every mountainside, let freedom ring. And if America is to become a great nation, this must become true. So let freedom ring. From the prodigious hilltops of New Hampshire, let freedom ring. From the mighty mountains of New York, let freedom ring. From the heightening Alleghenies of Pennsylvania, let freedom ring. From the snow-capped Rockies of Colorado, let freedom ring. From the curvaceous slopes of California, but not only that, let freedom ring from Stone Mountain of Georgia. Let freedom ring from Lookout Mountain of Tennessee. Let freedom ring from every hill and molehill in Mississippi. From every mountainside, let freedom ring. And when this happens, when we allow freedom to ring, when we let it ring from every village and every hamlet, from every state and every city, we will be able to speed up that day when all of God's children, black men and white men, Jews and Gentiles, Protestants and Catholics, will be able to join hands and sing in the words of the old Negro spiritual, free at last, free at last, thank God Almighty, we're free at last.
Thank you.
Ladies and gentlemen, please welcome to the stage Aaliyah Jackson singing I Want You Back.
Thank you.
MLK, The Voice, Part 1. Voice first top finalists in the live show. Welcome back for her ninth week, singing Emotion, Kayla Andrews. Next up, Our next finalist is Miss Michaela Shirley. She's coming to you singing My Funny Valentine. Give her a hand.
Here's your
Kayla Shirley. Give her another round of applause. Two contestants. Kayla Andrews and Kayla Shirley.
In 1939, classical singer Marian Anderson became a precursor to the Civil Rights Movement when she was refused permission by the Daughters of the American Revolution to sing in front of an integrated audience at Constitution Hall. But with the help of First Lady Eleanor Roosevelt, she performed Easter Sunday, April 9th, 1939, on the steps of the Lincoln Memorial in Washington, D.C. More than 75,000 attended, and millions were listening on the radio. Among her enthralled radio listeners, the 10-year-old Martin Luther King Jr. Washington for Jobs and Freedom. King later said that Anderson's 1939 Lincoln Memorial concert was a formative experience for him. It was imprinted on his mind, Dr. King quoted, one of the centerpiece songs at a dramatic moment in his 63 address.
This will be the day when all God's children will be able to sing with new meaning. My country, 'tis a sweet land of liberty. Land where my fathers died, land where the pilgrims pride. From every mountainside, let freedom ring. Let freedom ring. Let freedom ring.
Sorry.
Next coming up, we have a wonderful classical singer today. And we have many of them that sung in Constitutional Hall. Let's welcome to the stage 12-year-old classical singer Jordan Marie Lewis to perform O Mia Bambina Caro in Italian, accompanied on the piano by Judy Green. The song that she's singing is a sad song. It's about lost love. Put your hands together for this wonderful young woman. She's 12 years old, ladies and gentlemen. Encourage her.
Thank you.
at Maurice Walker and friends perform a dance number.
I don't know why I didn't come.
Mr. Darius Howard, woo! Also known as Unspoken Ambition, as he comes to you to tell a story in mind. There are many ways to tell a story, and Darius Howard will give us a spiritual message as a mind. Put your hands together for Darius.
Woo! Come on, Darius!
When I wanted to give in, seems like the day will never come. But I had to encourage me and find the strength to believe that I
lifting him
Do I have a few more minutes? I won't keep you all night. Says the Spirit helpeth our infirmity, which means the Spirit comes together and takes on the yoke. In other words, the Holy Ghost is feeling your drive. The Holy Ghost is feeling your temper. The Holy Ghost is feeling your energy. And He didn't leave you by yourself, but the Holy Ghost is yoking with you. And what He's saying is, I'm not gonna take it by myself. But if you will understand it, and all you gotta do is will it, then I will help you through. But you can't be caught between two opinions, leaving and coming back. But you gotta make up your mind, Lord, I'll be here. Stand with you until you work it out, because the Holy Ghost on the day of Pentecost, it sat on them. I feel like preaching in here. Give somebody a high five and say, when I need to do the right thing, I need the Holy Ghost sit on me. When my flesh is at the other level, sit on me.
Mason Temple Church was a place Dr. King spoke in 1968. Welcome to the Mason Temple Church, Memphis, Tennessee.
Praise the Lord, praise the Lord, praise the Lord.
Praise the Lord.
The Bible declares, let everything that have breath, what? Praise you, the Lord. We have gathered together here at the Mason Temple to have church, to let the Spirit touch us this evening, to let God shine some light on the horrible things happening to our people across the country. I know many of you are still raw from the outcome of Mr. Brown and Ferguson, and Mr. Garment in New York, and the other unjust rulings in our country today. But I want you to think about the Spirit of the Lord and keep peace. as a priority as we move throughout this process. Well, can we have a selection by the choir led by our brother Elijah Ellis?
Come on, just lift your hands and worship with us tonight. How many know that he's a great God? He's an exceedingly abundant above all that you can ask for. He's Alpha and Omega, beginning and end, creator of everything. Oh, hallelujah.
Water turned into wine. Open the eyes of the blind. There's no one like you. None like you.
Oh, hallelujah.
Into the darkness you shine, and out of the ashes we rise. There's no one like you. None like you.
Can't you lift your hands and help me say, oh, God is greater.
And he's stronger. Lord, you are higher.
Yeah.
This is not the first time we as people have endured such a thing. We have survived being taken from our own land and brought to a place unknown. We have survived being put into slavery. We have survived through Jim Crow laws. But this time, oh, y'all ain't hear me. But this time, we will break every chain of this unconstitutional treatment.
And if I was asked a question by the Almighty, if he would ask me, Martin Luther King, which age would you like to live in? I would take my mental flight by Egypt, and I would watch God's children in their magnificent trek from the dark dungeons of Egypt through, or rather across the Red Sea, through the wilderness on toward the promised land. And in spite of its magnificence, I wouldn't stop there. I would move on by Greece and take my mind to Mount Olympus. And I would see Plato, Aristotle, Socrates, Euripides, and Aristophanes assembled around the Parthenon. And I would watch them around the Parthenon as they discussed the great and eternal issues of reality. But I wouldn't stop there. Like anybody, I would like to live a long life. Longevity has its place. But I'm not concerned about that now. I just want to do God's will. And he's allowed me to go up to the mountain. And I've looked over and I've seen the promised land. I might not get there with you, But I want you to know tonight that we as a people will get to the promised land. And I'm so happy tonight. I'm not worried about anything. I'm not fearing any man. Mine eyes have seen the glory of the coming of the Lord.
Break Every Chain. That was Quandra Woods dancing to Break Every Chain, accompanied by Mrs. Alice Penn and Mrs. Tiffany Smith, and the wonderful, wonderful choir from Memphis, Tennessee. Right now we're going to bring to the stage Destiny Green singing A Change Is Going to Come.
It's been a long time.
Miss Destiny Green, Change When It Comes. We are at this time going to give out our awards. Presenting the awards, Mrs. Lourdes Swartz, President of PA Family Coalition, Mr. Kelly Summerford, our wonderful director of the MLK Performing Arts Showcase. We have Ms. B. Lewis, also Ms. Katrina McKinney, and Ms. Sharita Smith. Okay. Our first awardees will be presented by Mr. Kelly Summerford, and that will be to Mr. Eric Wolfert, accepting on behalf of Mr. Joseph Massaro. Mr. Massaro is getting the award, the Leadership Award, and accepting on his behalf is Mr. Eric Wolfert. This award is because of the Hilton Hotel and their support for the last 13 years of this program. So give them a round of applause. Accepting on behalf of Mr. Brian Hudson of the Pennsylvania Housing Finance Agency is Mr. Theodore Jackson, Mr. Ted Jackson. School District, and we have with us the principal of John Harris High, Mr. Eugene Spales. And Mr. Spales also will accept on behalf of Dr. Sybil Knight Burney, and they're getting the Dream Catcher Award. Our next award. We have two student awards, and our first award goes to Mr. Maurice Walker. Receiving a $25 check. Thank you. Well, you know, she got a little We're waiting on Quandra Woods to come to the stage. We're presenting you an award, and these young people are getting this award because they have made the most achievement in the last several years. They've been with us a while. When they first started out, they were really young and trying to learn how to do everything. And so because they have made the most progress in the last several years, they're getting this award. And along with this award is a $25 check for Miss Quandra Woods. Drumline, give him a round of applause. Please welcome to the stage CASA student vocals. The march. March very quietly, protesting. Those were very trying times and trying days. Please welcome to the stage CASA student vocals singing an original song titled Redemption.
What's this all about?
desire. Accepted in two different colleges for her theater arts. Give her a round of applause.
Thank you.
spell on you. Because you're mine. You're
you are my own.
to the stage, hip hopping, pop locking breakers, Brian Frazier, Melvin Sanboy, Luis Manchin, and Patrick Paredes. Oh, come on, you can do better than that.
I'm gonna go.
do that one day, and it didn't work. Please give a warm welcome to Christopher Carvel as he sings the John Lennon song, Imagine. A warm welcome.
Thank you. Yeah. dangerous wasteland ever sent for war. Despite its infinite emptiness, it's ruled by savage beasts and primitive men. Rugged landscapes are breeding grounds of death. Only those mobile enough to scavenge and brutal enough to pillage will survive. With no place to hide, every man is for himself. You're the hunter. Or you are hunted!
ninth week in the MLK, The Voice. Coming on stage now is 11-year-old Haley Bach. Rolling in the Deep is the song for her.
There's a fire starting in my heart, reaching a fever pitch as we meet out the dark. Finally, I can see you crystal clear. Go ahead and tell me out in Ale or Shiver. See how I leave with every piece of you. Don't underestimate the things that I will do. There's a reaching a fever pitch as we meet out the dark. The scores I know the remind me of. I can't help feeling that we almost had it all. The scores I know the leave me breathless. I can't help feeling we could have had it all.
John Legend.
Amen. Let me see. shake the pain. I'm trying to find a way to stay. Please stay. It's written all over my face. I can't function the same when you're not here. I'm calling your name and no one's there. And I know one thing you'll see. Nobody has it easy. I still can't believe.
Curtis A. Andrew III, drum and the bass, Keith Simpson from Philadelphia on the drums. John Johnson lead guitar. Houston Williams on the sax. Louis Woodyard Jr. percussions. Tony Catalano guitar. John Stout trumpet. Mike Mingo trombone. Yvonne Cruz keyboard. And our exceptional singers, Alice Penn vocals, and Tiffany Smith vocals. And I'd like to have a special thank you to the ushers provided by the Harrisburg Boys and Girls Club. We have some men here today from several fraternities, from the Kappas and from the Masonic Hall, and also from the Alphas helping us out. I'd like to thank you. Mary Alice Crossan and her team for being with us today. And we have an exceptional team of people that were here working with us on various things all day today. I'd like to thank Houston, Hudson Schwartz, and I want to call the artists. And if they come up, please give them a round of applause. They're coming out to do the finale. Give them a round of applause.
Still enough time to figure
thank you for Daniel Ann, Kayla Andrews, Jordan Andrews, Sam Arnold, Kelly Bach, Christopher Carvell, William Kennedy Chisholm III, Joy Christian, Elijah Ellis, Dane Fields, John Fraser, Alexis George, Michael Giles, Yanelais Gonzalez, Eugene Green, Destiny Green, Camille Hernandez, Darius Howard, Thea Jackson, Dr. Jeter, Sierra Kamara, Rachel Knight, Orion Lane, Jordan Marie Lewis, Mason Lewis, Louise Manchin, Charlie Miller, Daniel Moses, Alon Nelson, Patrick Paredes, Desiree Phillips, Jared Pickney, Cameron Roberts, Yana Robinson, Melvin Sanborn, Michaela Shirley, Candy Slaughter, Autumn Smith, Lanae Smith, Leonard Smith, Rod Smith, Taylor Stossel, Taryn Thomas, Rachel Thompson, Maya Waters, Quandra Woods. And we'd like to again thank Hutchins Sports as our assistant to the director, Rachel Thompson, the principal choreographer, Kelly Summerford. Drama coaches Jody Overton, Kelly Summerford, George Struve, Phil Spinnett. Vocal coaches Al Spence, Tiffany Smith, and Kirsten Andrews. Production assistants Joy Christian, Charles Bennett, Jeff Woodruff, and Todd Rexbaugh. Staff Barbara Lamarra, Catherine L. McKinney. Makeup, hair designers, dressers, and props, Andrea Fulton, and the ABW Productions. Adriel Fulton Crossan, Alicia Lane, Nikki Travis, Paris Reed, Todd Abney, Cheryl Baskerville, Crystal Manning, Diane White, Renee Walker, Sonya Woodward, Terrell Selden, and Stacey Phillips. We want to thank the Harrisburg County. That's Timothy Carter, Anthony Elliott, Devontae Grady, Janiyah Henderson, Purcell Lane, Jeremiah Lewis, Sean Nolte, Andre Reed, Dwayne Richardson, Curtis Sims, and Orion Lane.